So in the previous section, we just checked the how Python works on the data variables, how integers and addition and subtraction are going to define in the Python. And in the next section, we will check how else if is going to work here. So as of now, the syntax is quite very much simple. And it is having like, suppose we are defining a variable a is equal to 4. And it is having syntax if a is equal to 4 colon, then automatically it will give the indent. So the print function, so indent will go to the next section, like print 4. It will give the a equal to 4. It will give the print 4. Any message you can give. If a equal to 3 colon, again print 3, then it will give the next value of the next section. So obviously first condition is true, then it is going to print 4. I'm copying the same code here and paste in the second line, a is equal to a minus 1. Okay, so it is going to print 3 here, because in the next section LF line is quite true. Okay, I'm right copying the same code here in order to represent the second value. So as of now, a is equal to 10, and it is going to last section, that is default value, and it is represented by else, and it will give print and the, let's say, any none value, and it will give we just run alt enter to represent the value. So it will give the different section, and we can have the zoom code, and it will give the none value. Okay, you just run the program and it will give none, because neither first nor second statement is true. Now we are going to print this next section a in the different value, and we are going to check the real world example in order to solve one application part. Okay, so this application part is very much simple, and we are going to solve this problem, like how this problem is solved. And I am going to write this entire problem, like first is number of exam 4, and second I'm going to input means, like as you have seen in C in C++ in the C language, we are having different context. So scanf, then enter the first marks, second marks, third mark. One by one, it's going to ask the four variables, about the four variables. Now, number of exams are 4, and we are going to add these values. I'm copying the same code here. And it is going to sum up all these value, and it will get the total output of the all exam number, the marks those have the scored by this particular students. Okay, so he is having 4 subjects, and we are going to total all the examination, exam 1 plus exam 2 and exam 3 and exam 4 and so on. Okay, So keeping in mind that you are going to write the same variable name as assigned previously, exam 1, exam 2, exam 3, and exam 4. Now, average is going to define all the variables, total and total divided by 4, means total number of subjects. So now, again, as we have seen in the previous section, previous lesson, that average, how to calculate the average value if average is equal to 50 and these different conditions, it will print student is passed. And if average is having different condition, it will give the number. And if average less than 50, else it is going to print thank for examination. So enter the marks, it will going to ask first marks, it is going to ask second mark, second, third examination marks, fourth examination marks, and then the student is passed, because it is going to have value greater than 50. So what is the value of average? Let's see. Average, Alt Enter.